Yeah, lastly, a few closing words about these large-scale language models that have been gaining popularity in recent years. So, of course, I couldn't cover all of them. There are too many out there. There may be hundreds, if not thousands, of them out there. But maybe to mention a few more, so for especially those for longer sequences that might be interesting. So there is, for instance, Transformer XL, which is a decoder-only model, similar to GPT. And also similar to GPT, it's trained to predict the next word in the sentence. However, in contrast to the regular GPT models, it's using some sort of hidden state to connect these input segments. So remember the GPT version 1, it used like a 512 sized input tokens. And this model here, this Transformer XL, can connect multiple of these 512 input tokens. So in a way, it's kind of like an RNN with transformer models in them. So this is like one approach for dealing with larger inputs. Another one is this Longformer, which stands for Long Document Transformer. And the attention mechanism scales quadratically, which is quite expensive, quadratically with the input size. So here they developed, for instance, a mechanism that only scales linearly with a sequence length instead of quadratically. So with that, they were able to process longer text segments, thousands of tokens, which is similar to the size of Roberta, for example. But again, this is just one of the ways. There are many other ways for making transformers also more efficient so that they can deal with longer inputs. So overall, one trend though with these language models is that they are becoming larger and larger and larger. So this is a figure from Hugging Face. It's I think it ends here in 2019. You can see we have Elmo. We haven't discussed Elmo, but GPT, let's say GPT, we discussed that. It's 110 million parameters. So this is in million. So people should label their y-axis, but I think this should be million. And then the BERT model with 340 million parameters, GPT-2 with 1.5 billion. We discussed GPT-3, which is 175 billion and so forth. So these becoming larger and larger. Luckily though, there are also a few methods that focus on efficiency. For example, you can see there are some smaller models, especially this Distill BERT. It's a small version of BERT that is also making things more accessible again, because these models are so large that we as normal people probably won't be ever able to train them, except you have for some reason access to a very, very, very large computer. But even if you have access to thousands of GPUs, it's probably a huge pain to train these large-scale language models, because there will be a lot of tinkering and engineering required to scale that up to that many GPUs. It's not just like plug and play. You would have to tweak a lot of things and be an expert coder and engineer to make that work. So nowadays, there was an interesting article I saw 2 months ago. So GPT-3 is now spewing out 4.5 billion words a day. I think they have an API around GPT-3, like commercializing it. And it is a very popular model that is also very popular nowadays in real-world applications. One problem, like I mentioned, the size of the models. There was also an interesting paper on the cost of training large natural language processing models. So here they have some numbers that are quite something. So for the 110 million parameter model, the GPT version one, for instance, they estimate the cost is between $2,500 and $50,000 just to train that. Or then if you have the BERT model or the GPT version 2 model, that's going like hundreds of thousands of dollars to millions of dollars just training these models. So it's quite impressive, but also kind of sad if you think of environmental costs. But it's also research in a way, so it's kind of interesting to see where things go, but I wish also things wouldn't be that expensive and not as, let's say, electricity hungry. So luckily, some people also focus on models for more or better efficiency. For instance, there is this reformer method, which replaces the dot product attention by local sensitivity hashing mechanisms, so also achieving n log n scaling instead of n squared memory costs and so forth. There's AllBird, which is a 5 times smaller version of BERT, but that reaches the same performance. So there are different approaches. There are approaches like the reformer, or also there's also the sparse transformer that I briefly mentioned, and there was this long former, which also has this tension mechanism that scales linearly with a sequence length. There are also the Stillbird. There are many, many different approaches, but just to highlight a few, right? So here, this one, the AllBird model is, for instance, also focused on compressing via pruning after training. So you train the model and then you prune so that you get smaller models. Okay, so this is it then for a whirlwind tour across these different large-scale language models. And lastly, maybe having a short code example in the next video, and then ending this very long lecture on RNNs and attention and transformer models.